My friend, you said we should do a lesson on how to use the plectrum. I have more lessons on it on my YouTube channel, Odishe Kef. So search for Odishe Kef, O-D-E-H-Y-I-E-K-E-F-F. It's my name. If you search me on YouTube, you'll find more lessons. I've rearranged the lessons from beginner playlist, intermediate playlist, and advanced playlist. So if you are a beginner or you want to learn the guitar, search for beginner lessons on my YouTube channel. There are a whole lot of lessons. But for the sake you've requested it on YouTube, Facebook here, I have to do it for you here and send you to where you can learn more as well. So going forward, you have to know the basics, how to hold the plectrum, how you can do your rehearsal, everything. So let's go to the board and do some things on how you can use the plectrum to play the guitar well. So let's go. We are using key C. I have C, this is C. So if you don't know the C, it means the question will not benefit you, or the answer will not benefit you. So this is C. So going forward, we have to use this C, or C, this finger. So let's use this because we are using a plectrum work. So we start from here. This is how we hold a plectrum. You have the plectrum like this. So sometimes you do the fingers like this. This is the first finger and the thumb. So we normally play the guitar this way. Sometimes play the guitar. So the same way, instead of using the fingers like this, the first finger like this, we replace the plectrum with the finger, the first finger. So let's put the plectrum on the finger, first finger like this, you see. Then we bend down the finger. So this is how it is. So we bend it down like this, you see. So when we bend it down, you see it has remained the plectrum. It has remained the plectrum there. It has taken the position of the finger, like instead of using it. So when we bend the first finger down, you see it has remained the plectrum. So let's go to the rehearsal, how we can use the plectrum. So this way, we start from the neck. Then we play one drop, one down, one top, one down. So this is the first step. So let's go to the right hand. I'm off this finger, this left hand is off. So here we play one top, from top to down, down to top. So let's take it. So not the fingers, I'm using the plectrum to play the guitar. One top, one down. So then we go to the fifth string the same way. Then we go to the fourth, third, second, first string. So let's do that again. let's take it slow again. That is the first step of learning. Then we play it 4 times. 4-4. That is ringing. We are doing it ringing. Then we add. So when we practice it more, you see, every day, then we go to the second step. The second step, we are using chromatic scale. When I say chromatic, we don't leave any notes in between the notes. So we played all the whole fingers, play this. So we start from the neck like this. Then we play top, down. So you see, then we move the next position, the second finger. Same string. So then we reverse it. Then let's do the ringing. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Then we go to the next string. That's the fifth. Then we play the second. So we do this to one top, one down, and all. Two, two, or four, four. You see, one, 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 but one top, one down. You see, either we play one top, one top, one down, the same note. One top, one down, the same note. Or one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So. Or. Then we go to then. So when we play from top to down, down to top, then we move to the forward until where we get tired. So tackling the plectrum work. I don't want us to waste much time on it, because it depends on you, the learner or the student, what you want to do with your plectrum or your guitar. So it's better to understand and rehearse more. So as time goes on, when you are done with this, you go to the surface, because the fact that you've asked for the plectrum work, it means you already know the surface. So we go to the surface and do the same with the surface. That is do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, ti, la, so, fa, mi, re, do. The same thing, do, down, top. So let's take it slow. play until you get tired. So double double. Ringing. So all the surfaces you know on the board, you run the same across. All the thing you know rehearse more across the fretboard. This lesson will be an intermediate on my YouTube channel. So you just search for the Audition Curve at YouTube. Go to YouTube and search for Audition Curve. If you search for Audition Curve, there are a whole lot of lessons from beginner, intermediate, and advanced. So all the guitar board work is under the beginning. Beginner lesson, because I've done a lot of lessons concerning the board, tuning pegs, position markers, how to form chord skills. They are all part of the beginner lesson. And intermediate deals with the melodic minor scale, pentatonic, augmented, all sorts of skills falls under the intermediate. And creation of chord, how to understand the chord well, creating of the other chords, diminished chords, minor, major seven chords, seventh chords, and other creating of the chords. The that is the second part of the chord formation and skills falls under the intermediate lesson. And cover songs, learning other people's songs, application of the skills and chords is advanced lesson. And playing other people's songs, that is the cover songs. They all fall under the advanced lesson. So search for my name, Audition Curve, on YouTube. There are a whole lot of more than 300 lessons there, from beginner to advanced. So choose your topic, go to the channel, learn, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel as well, because we are all one big family. If you subscribe to the channel, you will never regret subscribing to the channel. There are a whole lot of lessons benefiting others. Others are benefiting from the channel, I tell you. So you just visit my YouTube channel as well. You are all wonderful to me. Thank you.